if you're wearing a mask and you're trying to sing and you start to get lightheaded and faint from breathing in what you've been breathing out and all of that, then you have a pass. You don't have to sing, but I sure love it when you do. Okay, here's another one. Y'all see this with me? The words are very easy. Just sing whoa, 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 whoa a bunch of times. That's what you sing. All right, here's your part. Come on. Sipping on a hot cup with a little lady in green. And I'm praying that the man I want to be, singing, God, please take all I need and fill me up with your love. Love, take these thoughts and I'm thinking love. Take these words and I'm speaking love. Amen. All right. Love, fill up all of my space. Stand back to my place. Only show love when I really know how loved I am. When it overtakes me, when it meets me, flowing from my heart to my hand. So I'm praying, Father, help my heart believe. Right now, you're singing the whole of me and fill me up with your love. Take these thoughts that I'm thinking of. Take these words that I'm speaking of. Thank y'all so much. Oh, it is, it really is amazing. I guess the old saying, you don't know what you got till it's gone, you know? And really and truly, because I have been doing this, some of you all know, this is not my first tour. I know, you're looking, thinking, he's so young. He surely just got started. But I have, my first album came out in 1987, y'all. That was like 30... and a bunch of years ago. And I was 12, I was just a child. It was a children's album, yeah, that's what it was. No, it was, those were the mullet years. Some of y'all remember the mullet years, right? Yes, that happened. Why do you have to do that, Paul? Why do you put that picture up there? Listen, we didn't know, guys, right? We didn't know there was going to be things like social media, the internet. Those things didn't exist at the time. We just thought it was a really cool hairstyle for just, you know, 15 minutes in the late 80s. And little did we know it would come back, at least for some of us, and haunt us over and over and over again. And that picture keeps showing up in that video. But here's the really cool thing about that. That was the first time. If you see on there, it says Billy Graham Classics. That was the first opportunity I had to be with Billy Graham. And I had the incredible blessing of being with him on several occasions and singing in his meetings and his gatherings, crusades. They call them Billy Graham Crusades. And it was amazing. I mean, you'll hear my story tonight. For a kid from Paducah, Kentucky, to ever get a chance to do something like that was just only God could dream up something that incredible and that amazing. And but when I see that picture, I think of this all the time, because I was so excited to call my grandmother and tell her I was going to be with Reverend Billy Graham. I knew she would just flip out. She'd be so excited, because she's one who taught me much about a love for music and prayed for me and took me to church and me and my brother and took us to music concerts and all of that. So I knew she'd be so excited. And sure enough, she was just thrilled, couldn't even believe it. But then the first thing she said was, now, you are going to get your hair cut for that, right? And so that picture is a very good life lesson for all of us. Always listen to your grandmother. They know. They just know. They have wisdom. They know. Had I listened to her, I might have been able to save myself a little bit of shame over the years of that mullet picture showing up. But anyway, I want to share some of my journey and my story with you tonight. And we're going to try to cover as much ground as we can, because there have been, like I said, a lot of songs and a lot of albums. And a lot of you have been a part of those with me and listened to them over the years, all the way back to cassette tapes and vinyl records, actually, yes. Yeah, that's crazy. I never had 8-track tape. I mean, I owned them, but I didn't have my face on the front of any 8-track tapes. That's the one format that I was not a part of. But we're going to go back as much as I can into some of those older albums, as well as some of the new music. So if you hear something you know and you know the words, you can help me sing it, because sometimes I might be known to forget them on occasion. But here's one. See if anybody remembers this. I hear you say your heart is aching, you got trouble in the making, and you ask if I'll be praying for you, please. And in keeping with convention, I'll say yes with good intentions, to pray that I'm making mention of your need. Since we have this moment here at heaven's door, just find out.